Hello everyone, my name is Ishan. Today I'll be talking about our work on cross-stitch networks for multitask learning. So in many cases, we have access to multiple forms of supervision. Some such supervision is relatively free to obtain, while other is more expensive. For example, surface normals can be obtained almost freely using a Kinect. So now let's look at the data distribution across these classes. We notice that the distribution is very skewed and many classes have very little data. So can we expect an alternate but free form of supervision to help improve performance across these classes? A standard way to do this is to use multitask learning. In this case, we have a completely shared network which predicts two outputs. But how do we know that a single representation will help both the tasks? We can split at a lower layer and get more task-specific representations. In fact, by continuing to do so, we can get an entire spectrum of architectures by splitting at various layers. And this is the standard way to do multitask learning, where we train and test all of these architectures. So let's do this for the tasks of normals and segmentation. So we train and test all of these 9 architectures and plot the relative performance with respect to the one task network. We notice that a single network improves performance for both these tasks. How about two new tasks, attributes and detection? We notice, again, that by training all these 9 network architectures and plot their relative performance. Unfortunately, the best networks for detection and attributes are different. In fact, no single network improves performance for both these tasks. So what are some problems with this standard approach? There is no principled way of exploring architectures. It's practically very expensive because you have to train and test all of them. It does not generalize across tasks. And one architecture may not improve across all tasks. So in this paper, we present a principled way to explore architectures without having to train all of them that can generalize across tasks. Because our method implicitly explores more architectures than mere splitting, it performs better than brute force search. So given two one-task networks, how do we combine or fuse them? According to an ancient idiom, a stitch in time saves 9. So maybe if we stitch things right, we won't have to train 9 networks. We do just that and use cross-stitching to combine two networks. More specifically, we add cross-stitch units between them. And these units model information sharing by learning linear combinations. So let's look at one of them in detail. A cross-stitch unit takes input activations from two tasks and learns a linear combination to produce outputs. Now, depending on the learned values of this linear combination, it can decide to have no sharing across tasks, or to have high sharing across tasks, or to find a middle ground. So let's look at some results. In this case, we notice that cross-stitch networks improve performance for both pairs of tasks, segmentation and normals, and attributes and detection. In fact, they perform better than one-task networks and brute force networks. How about categories with little data? In this case, we plot the change in performance relative to the baseline network and notice that we improve their performance significantly. The same trend holds for attributes, where we improve significantly for classes with little data. For more information, please visit our poster. Thank you.